Welcome to tonight's game. It promises to be a good one between the Syracuse Orange and the Dayton Flyers. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
There are two solid power forwards that will be matched up against one another. Yes, it'll be a treat to watch them battle on both ends of the court. They both have the potential to take control of the paint and the game.
The top 25, a list at over 300 schools, try to make it on, and we get to watch two of them go at it head-to-head, Dick.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, I've been waiting for this one. These teams have some talented individuals who also play great team basketball. We will be entertained.
Blocks the shot. Ball's going to stay here. I think that one deserves another look.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, that's how you throw it down. Bad decision there by the freshman.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. They work the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper and come up short. On the left side. They'll give him that pass all night long. Court. Loose ball, great play. Trying to pack it inside, in the lane, scores it. Coleman handles the pass, can't connect. Trying to feed the low block. Coleman picks up the foul. First team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Brad, he's got that first year of experience under his belt. So this season, his team is going to be looking for him a lot more.
In some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
Down inside for the bucket. Off the glass and no good.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. There's the rejection. They get out on the break.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
On the wing for two, he makes the shot. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Cross court. Turnaround jumper. Nope. that drive to the hoop, Dick.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
Tries for two. Drains the shot. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down in the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. This guy's a talent. He can face you up, play back to the basket. He's a good rebounder and a solid defender.
The shot's off target. Sinks the shot. On the right side. Inside. Jumper off the mark. The shooting guard with the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter from the corner and score it. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Let's take a second look at this three. Gave it up for the bucket. It's good. Takes the shot. In and out. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Looking to run now. Number four is whistled for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
With the pair. First shot, good. Both free throws go. He may be in some trouble here. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, the four around one motion offense is a good offense when the team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
The Orange now running a zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Richardson on the left side. Goes up. Scorches the net with a J.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
For two. Off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. He hammers it home. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
You know, Brad, as a coach, you teach your players to read the defender. And when he's not looking, deliver the pass.
Looking for a good shot. From downtown. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Gets up to make the block. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Let's go back and take another look at this one, Dick.
Hey, now that's taking it strong to the hoop. Look at him throw it down.
Gave it up. Puts up the jumper. Coleman is getting it done for his team right now.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game. There it is, Jam City.
The Flyers did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Anytime you get a player in a high post, you put pressure on the defense, and that can lead to big breaks over the course of the game.
Balanced teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
They feel they are more successful when they focus their attention on doing a bit of both, Brad. They have the personnel to be able to play up-tempo at one end and play in the half court at the other.
Working it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. He nails the bucket. Number four takes the feed. They go into the low block with a deep shot from outside. The missed shot. Out on the wing.
There's the trap.
He puts up the J. Nails the jumper. They work it around the perimeter. The senior commits a turnover. The orange looking to attack in transition.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and it's blocked. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Let's check out this dunk one more time, Mr. Vitale.
He took this one strong and hard, Mr. Nestlin. That, my friend, makes a coach proud.
Off the inbound. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Rejected. They're called for a shot clock violation.
Very poor ball movement, Brad. The defense is doing a great job of keeping the ball out of scoring positions.
Out on the right wing with a great block. Here they go into transition. Is this defense ever quick to recover?
It's called conditioning, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. He shoots from the corner. Poor shooting behind that arc lately, Dick.
Yeah, they can't seem to find their stroke yet, Brad.
He shoots from the deep corner. They get it to go. Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper.
Inside.
Fires away. Off the mark. Cross court. Tries for two. No good. Swatted away. Oliver, subpar performance is just destroying his confidence.
Someone may have to talk to him. He needs to get back on track.
They look to get it to the inside.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
That's a great drive to the basket.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
Around 8 minutes remaining. They work it around the perimeter from the corner. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Looking for a good shot. There's a slam. They'll work it around the arc. Turnover by the senior. The Flyers now looking for a basket in transition. For the bucket. He gets the bucket.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Two. Gets it to fall. How about the great job of getting to the basket right there, Dick?
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong. Turnover committed by the senior.
Bad decision there by the senior. Goes up for two. They got it. On the outside. 6 minutes left on the game clock. On the dribble, gives it up. Takes the jumper. Nope. He grabs the board. Tries for two. Buried it. On the outside. For the bucket. Oh, yes.
Pushing that basketball.
Now trying to feed the low block. He shoots the jumper. Bust the J. 5 minutes left in the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
He's been playing like he has one thing on his mind, winning. He's been doing whatever it takes to get baskets and stops. We'll have to wait and see if that translates into a win here today.
They'll throw this one in from the side. On the right side. 10 to shoot. And a momentary look from three-point land. Number 35 with the foul. First personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
Can. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. They've got him trapped.
Look at that spacing.
A little two-man action. On the elbow, they feed down. A penny shot rejected. 4 minutes left on the game clock. They run it up into transition. For two, he hits it. Number 20 subs back out of the court.
You'll see the D quickly readjust, Brad.
Cross court.
Great press.
Had his shot blocked. Number zero gets the ball. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Excellent jump shot right there.
They work the perimeter. About 3 minutes remaining.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Pushes it up. He shoots from the corner. Off the mark. The small forward gets the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. They move it into the front court and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number 20 gets the ball. Great shot. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He tries a three ball, busts the jumper. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Let's take another look at this deep three. Looking for a good shot. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. The point guard gets the pass. Working it around the perimeter. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Up for two. He nails the shot. About a minute remaining. Inside. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Jumper won't go. Davis handles the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries for two. He's money with the shot.
Trying to go inside.
Number 22 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Bella commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players that have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from their conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
And he got them both. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on.
He gets the foul, and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
And here's a look at the freshman.
Your first year playing basketball at this level is definitely an eye-opening experience. The players are bigger and the game is faster. But if you can adjust and find ways to help your team win, it can be a memorable season.
Into their zone motion now. At the horn. Scorches the net with a J. At halftime, the Orange are ahead by two. Dayton coughed up the ball way too many times in that first half,
Dick. They certainly did, Brad. I've said it a million times. Turnovers kill momentum. I don't see a lot of these kids taking my advice out there.
Well, let's take a look at our game summary to this point so far, Dick.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Number 20 subs back into the thick of things, Dick.
Hey, you can't keep a guy like this out for too long, Brad. He's just too valuable.
Gave it up. With the jumper. Gets the J to fall. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
Way out on the right wing. Man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Knocks it down. The small forward with the ball. Too physical. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
With the free one. First one is good. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch. Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
That trap could spell some trouble. For the bucket, off the glass and no good. Davis handles the pass. Cross court. He manages to keep it in play. That's not a good pass.
many teams get bumped on screens when you inbounds the ball from the baseline.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
10 seconds on the shot clock. With the big shot. Sweet fadeaway, Jay. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points.
Oh, nice rejection. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
The man is off the charts, Brad. Up and inside.
For two. Sinks it.
That's Matador defense. Nobody coming over. Nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
The freshman's a bit careless with the ball.
On the left side. Tries to get the D to bite. Goes up for two.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Tries for two. Gets it to go.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Ah, I didn't realize my partner was a high-riser.
Out on the wing. They're working around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
He shoots from left of the circle, nails the jumper. Fed the low block. He attempts the jump shot. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
It in for the bucket. He gets it to go. He cut back door and received the pass.
It's great seeing those types of plays. That's team basketball.
The power forward gets the ball.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Trying to feed inside. Number zero, he got the layup to go and the foul is called.
Hey, he saw that he was going to get fouled, but he stuck to the path in spite of it.
I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Loose ball, kept in. Looking for a good shot. Goes up with a shot. And score it. Number 21 gets the ball. Trying to pack it inside. And back they come the other way.
I tell you what, pressure. Look at him take the ball to the length of the court. No one stopped the basketball.
They'll work it around the arc. Loose ball. Great play. Trying to feed the low block.
Turnover by the senior.
Oh,
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
The Flyers have really been able to get it done here as a team today, Dick.
You know, everyone's been getting it about. Passing, rebounding, taking the ball to the hoop. A great team effort will always keep a team in it.
Ten to shoot now. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
And the block. On the outside. Who wants it? And he saves it. Loose ball kept in for two. Knocks it down. On the outside, the senior commits a turnover. Moving it around the perimeter. He gets the rejection. There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
Momentary look from three-point land. Turnover by the senior. Goes up for two. You betcha. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. On the right side. Down inside. Blocked. He grabs the rebound. The Orange looking to attack in transition for the bucket. Off the mark with that shot.
Spacing.
For two. Off the glass and no good. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Nice shot. Did a great job of getting to the hoop on that one, Richard.
Well, he spotted an opening and he just absolutely great first step and he exploded to the goal.
Bust the J. They work the perimeter. Tries for two. Scorches the net. Now that was a great play right there, Dick.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
He tries the jumper. Missed it. Got it in the low block. Number 20 picks up the foul. Third personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
A chance for two. He makes it. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
At the charity strike. The Flyers want to up the pressure here, Dick, and I think they're going to change the tempo of the game with their defense.
You know, it's a great decision, Brad, if you have the right personnel to play full-court defense.
There was no doubt about that one. Number zero gets the ball. Top of the circle, the missed shot. Perimeter with the J, nails the J.
That'll take some pride on the defensive end.
He goes up with it, scores it. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. With a bucket, drains it. There's a double team waiting there. Looking for a good shot. Loose ball, great play. And we'll head back down to the other end. Points of the paint are huge, and these guys have really been coming up big in that category.
Well, if you get the ball inside this many times, your team is going to be out in front. I like how determined they've been in getting the ball in the paint.
Working it around the perimeter. Two. No. We'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick.
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Goes up with it. Off the mark.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I got a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Out on the left wing. Gave it up. Goes up for two. There was no doubt about that one. Down in the low block. Goes up. Scorches the net with a J. They're working around the perimeter. He tries to knock down the three. Knocked it down. Boy, terrible execution on offense. We're at the 7-minute mark. He goes for three. They get it to go. Steals the pass. It's a fast break possibility. Triple F swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Great block shot. Ball's going to stay down here. Let's check out this dunk one more time, Mr. Vitale.
That's a strong take. A strong, strong take to the goal.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
And the ball is saved. Great job. For the bucket. The layup is good. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and off.
Up and in. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Looks for a three-pointer. He knocks down the jumper. Now, let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent. To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
It's good. Dick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nestler. The high post is a gold mine if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
Turnover committed by the freshman. The Flyers now looking for a basket in transition. For the deuce, he doesn't get the hoop to ball. About 5 minutes remaining. Inside. For two. Rims out. The small forward receives the ball. Goes up for two. With a layup. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
You know, he did a great job putting the ball on the floor and getting to the basket.
Up and inside.
Drains it. Working around the perimeter. Bad decision there by the senior. About 4 minutes remaining. Looking for a good shot. He goes for the trifecta. Bust the J. The feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Nice pass to the low block. Nails the jumper. They'll work it around the arc. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Dumps it in. He goes up with it. Rims out.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town.
He rejects it.
They're trying to work that ball inside, but all they're doing is forcing up bad shots now.
Well, we'll see how long it is before the coach calls a timeout to get everyone back on the same page. Puts up the jumper. Nails the J. About 2 minutes remaining. The outside tries for two with a lay-in. For the bucket, off the mark with a shot. Davis receives the pass on the outside. Jumper. Richardson handles the pass, goes up with it, gets the J to fall. 1 minute left to go. Moving it around the perimeter.
Bad decision there by the senior.
Now on the run for the deuce. Sinks the shot. The small forward receives the ball. Nice shot. All the fans are open. Why'd he throw it to him? Sideline inbounds. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Bad decision there by the freshman. So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
With limited time remaining, it's very important that the players have a clear understanding of what the coach wants them to do when they return to the floor. They'll have to be on the same page, or else it could cost them the game.
What mindset, Dick, do coaches want their players to have when they leave a timeout?
Well, for me, Brad, I wanted my players to have a clear understanding of what the objectives were for the upcoming possessions. Timeouts are a great way to get your team back on track and a way to really alter the tempo of the game. Great coaches have a knack for calling timeouts at the right times.
And we're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. Shot clock is dead. Davis receives the ball. He attempts the three. He buries the jumper. Let's get back to the action. Richardson receives the ball. He dials long distance. He misses the jumper.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
While we've got a second, let's take a look at two individuals selected, Dick, as our players of the game.
They were both great to watch all game long. Their coaches and teammates have to be happy with what they've done out there today.